You'll have tumors like this too. How are you going to approach this tumor? Huge tumor. This is entire limbic lobe. It starts from the uncus, goes all the way to posterior parahippocampus, isthmus, and then posterior cingulate gyrus. Look at this. How are we going to approach this? Occipital interhemispheric, supracerebellar transtentorial. He's very young and super confused, very significant peripheral visual deficits, speech deficits, and memory deficits. And he's been this way 6 months and 11 centimeter tumor. Okay, I'm going back again. How are we going to approach this? One way, multiple ways, two ways. Okay, another way. I'm asking these questions before surgery, and I decided to go ahead with the first stage. I'll set ultra anterior approach, transsylvian pretemporal. I'm going to take the temporal pole and go from there and see how much I can remove. So we did that. So we exposed ICA. You see anterior choroidal, PCA here, and the brainstem. Mobilizing away, cotton paddy covering the oculomotor nerve, entire anterior choroidal course here, and keep moving until you stop, you cannot see anymore. And we came with the second stage 2 days later, supracerebellar transtentorial approach. I'm cutting the tentorium here, and I knew this is not gonna enough, but I want to give try. Most difficult part in this region is going to be reaching the posterior cingulate gyrus, superior aspect of the tumor. And you have to preserve the veins. You have to be very careful. It's a critical area. And I am skeletonizing these arteries, taking the site feeders, and preserving the veins that look real veins, taking the veins that look arterialized by the tumor blood, taking them, okay? So respecting the normal veins and taking the only tumor veins. See, is I'm extending the cut on the temporal lobe. I'm going further laterally, and tumor luckily has a distinct color from the brain, allows me to work around it. And that's, it didn't do it. There was still residual. I came occipital interhemispheric this time. And craniotomy was done anyway with the initial. I went all the way and met with my all previous two surgical resections. And pathology was grade 2 astrocytoma, WHO grade 2. And he started improving immediately. And in 1 year, he went back to his profession. And he's been tumor-free actually 7 years now. He's been doing very well. So this, again, this case is the shoulder, combining all these. Sometimes one approach may not be enough. Don't give up. These patients are young, and we know that only predictor in the long-term outcome in low-grade gliomas, extent of resection. Same in the high-grade gliomas. So anatomy helped me? Yes. Pathological anatomy? Yes. You need to know normal anatomy. You need to know pathological anatomy, disturbed anatomy. Anatomy disturbed by the pathology. Personal preferences, we know in many institutions, people either they like doing the subtemporal approach or transsylvian approach or transcortical approach or whatever approach. We train in one way, but you don't confine yourself in one way. You have to be versatile.